Welcome. Welcome to New Creation Woman. I'm Pastor Laura Lee of Media.
And I'm Pastor Patty Scahill.
And our special guest today
is Terry Herring.
Yes, thank you. Terry's back with us. Yes. If you missed it, you need to go back and get the other program. It's on our website, newcreationwoman.org.
Yes.
If you missed Terry, she shared quite a bit. Thank you. Thank you for coming back.
Yeah,
Terry's a worshiper, and she was sharing in the other program some of her history and her life. And this program, she's going to also share with you about the worship part of her life, because she is a beautiful singer, and the Lord is teaching her also to play keyboards. And we were just talking too, you know, before the program, even if you're not a singer or worshiper, the Bible tells us that we are to worship Him in spirit and truth.
That's right.
And we're all to be worshipers, right?
Yes, that's right.
Because worship is it's a weapon. It's one of the weapons of our warfare, so that we can combat, because, you know, the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy.
Yes.
And he wants us, if he can't kill us, he wants you to be miserable. So, but we overcome him by the blood of the Lamb and
word of our testimony.
Amen.
So, Terry, how did you get into worshiping when you were a little girl? Did you sing?
Well, I always used to like to sing.
Oh.
I used to sing with my sisters. We'd harmonize.
It
was just something, you know, I like to do. When I got saved, born again, in the end of my 20s, the Lord opened the door for me to just get out there and start singing.
Wow.
And worship songs. And I used to sing with my sister. And we'd go around and sing. Then I sang with a different company of people. I was on worship teams for the last 30 years, I guess.
Wow. Wow.
So the Lord has showed me a lot.
That's a long time.
He showed me a lot about worship, that worship is a mighty key. Worship is for all of us, not just those who sing, play an instrument, or dance. Worship is a lifestyle. Worship is warfare. Worship is it. It breaks yokes off of us.
Yes.
And I've been delivered from things just from worship.
Mm-hmm.
And any trials and things I've gone on in my life, worship is a place you can go to where you can get into the Lord's presence and heal you.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And not only that, but you express back the love you have for Him, and it just transforms you.
And even if you can't sing, I've noticed sometimes, you know, in our house, or when it seems like a lot of things are happening and they're not, things aren't exactly going the way they should be going.
Mm-hmm.
When I put on worship, all that oppression or depression or whatever is trying to come on me and in my house has to go. Because
it
can't be there. You can't have the worship and the enemy at the same time.
It
cuts through. So that's another tool. If you can't sing, if you can, that's great. But put on the music. Right?
Yeah, put on the music.
Right, because it'll dispel. It just dispels the darkness and the oppression, and it'll shift.
Yes.
It'll shift the atmosphere. And more importantly, it shifts us.
Yes.
Right.
You know, it gets our heart lined up with the Lord no matter what's going on. And then when we come out of that and we're come out of our prayer closet and we've been worshiping and we come out, everything is different, you know, whether it changed or not, it's different because we're different.
We're different.
Yes.
And how do you worship? What do you?
I put on worship music, especially worship music that will immediately take me into the heart and the intimacy with the Lord. Not so much all the time high praise that is real fast or anything. I love that.
Yeah.
I love doing that. And probably when I'm driving, I do that. But in the morning, it's like I just want to come to the Lord and worship Him in intimacy.
Yes.
And so that's usually what I do in my morning worship time. And I have favorites that I go to, don't we all?
Yes, we do.
You know, we have favorites that we know that we want to sing to the Lord, or that it ministers to Him and to us, because He wants us to receive too. We receive from His presence and intimacy.
Yes.
And the scripture that I had, there was a scripture that I pulled up because the Lord dropped this in my spirit when we were talking, is Psalm 96 and verse 1, mm-hmm. and it says, sing unto the Lord a new song.
Yes.
And all the earth. And,
yes.
and then it goes on, if you ever want to read anything, Psalm 96:1. But singing unto the Lord a new song is singing in the Spirit. It's just singing what is coming out of your heart. Mm-hmm. You know, it may rhyme, it may not, but it's singing unto the Lord a new song.
Yes.
It's a new day, a new song. And it's beautiful to do that.
Amen.
And many times the Lord gives us that, to sing.
Yes. Amen. Mm-hmm. No, he
beautiful.
Gives that to you. Yes.
But what I was going to say is the sound that comes out of us, mm-hmm. praise, worship, it actually pushes the enemy out of our territory.
Amen.
So when we sing and worship, you don't like have to be a singer,
right.
but it's just the worship, it's just the praise. You change your atmosphere around you.
Amen.
And there is a sound that comes out and it changes not only in your atmosphere, but it reaches into the heavenlies.
Mm-hmm.
And that we are actually changing things around us, and the sound is going up and it reaches him,
mm-hmm.
and then his presence comes down in such a beautiful way. But the enemy and God's spirit can't cohabitate, really.
Right.
So
yeah.
when you worship, you're pushing all that out.
Yes.
The darkness and his light comes in.
Yes.
So, and then worship, like we were saying, brings healing, deliverance.
Mm-hmm.
Like many times, many things have lifted off of me just worshiping.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And like you said about the intimacy, that's mm-hmm. really where he wants us to be.
Yes.
Is to have that intimate encounter with him.
Yes.
And so I found, like, over the years in my growth and throughout my journey, that's what it's about. The intimacy,
mm-hmm.
the presence of the Holy Spirit, and then what he wants to download and speak into us.
Yes.
So it's powerful.
Amen.
It changes us.
Mm-hmm. Amen. I just found a scripture that I had written before in Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2.
That's the one I had too.
Oh, the sacrifice.
Yes, the sacrifice of worship.
I'll just read it and you can comment on it.
Yeah.
Therefore, I urge you, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies a living and holy sacrifice, mm-hmm. acceptable to God, which is your spiritual service mm-hmm. of worship.
Yes.
And verse 2 says,
yes.
and do not be conformed to the world, but transformed by the renewing of your mind,
right.
so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect.
Amen.
And that's one translation.
Yes.
I know different translations mm-hmm. read differently. Mm-hmm. Maybe you have a different translation.
It was pretty much the same, except this is your true and proper worship.
Oh, that's good.
Okay.
That's good.
So, and then the renewing of our mind, I mean, worship can come together with the word, and that's all transforming.
Yes.
Yes.
Because worship isn't just singing. Worship's a lifestyle. Worship is time in the word. Worship is worshiping with, lifting your hands up. Mm-hmm. Worship is everything that you carry mm-hmm. through in your life.
That's
for
right.
everything.
And that's why in my Bible, or this mm-hmm. one version, it said the sacrifice, because sometimes it's a sacrifice.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's a battle.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's a battle to get into worship.
Right?
Yeah. For sure.
There's a lot of stuff coming in.
Distractions.
Yes. Distractions. We could talk about that. Isn't that
right,
one of the tools?
Yes, it is.
Yes,
it is.
The enemy?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And many times before getting up for worship, what you feel comes against you.
Yes.
That you say, I don't even, mm-hmm. but then
right.
you just take the step out and boom, mm-hmm. his spirit comes and
mm-hmm.
The devil's a liar.
Yes,
I mean, he'll try to keep you from coming into that place
him. That's right.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
And the flesh will fight too, because the flesh wants to, we begin to have those feelings of, I shouldn't do it, or I don't want to do it,
or I need to do this.
Or I have that to do. Yeah, exactly.
Women, we see torn in 50 directions.
And we have to, and you know what? We have to take ourselves and say, no, you're going to do this. If, mm-hmm. Or if we pick up, move your phone somewhere else. If you're not playing the music on your phone, move it somewhere else, because you might want to get on it and check mm-hmm. other things
right.
out. Move it aside and just worship
in that time, that presence.
Turn it off.
Turn it off. Set it aside.
Yeah.
And if you pick it back up, put it down again. Just know that you can't.
Right.
Yeah.
We don't have to just because we have a phone mm-hmm. and it's ringing all the time or people are texting us, right. you don't have to answer.
Right.
You know,
right.
you can become a slave to that device. So, oh my gosh,
exactly.
there's emails and texts and phone calls and
distractions.
Right. Yes. distractions.
Right. Yeah. That's what it is.
Yes. So how do you, you know, it says sometimes we think that worship is just for church, but it's not, like
no,
you said.
No, it's a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle. I mean, so many times in the Bible it talks about worship, but mm-hmm. it wasn't always just singing and dancing and mm-hmm. expressing. It's our heart towards God mm-hmm. is what it is. And it's our obedience and everything we do.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. There's a scripture, and this even goes back to Genesis. In Genesis 22, verse 5, Abraham mm-hmm. that said to the young men, "Stay here with the donkey, and mm-hmm. I and the lad will go over there, and we will worship and return."
That's the one
to
I was just thinking well, when he said, yeah. "Where before yeah. that?" That was the one that came to
and
me.
And I
about.
Wonder what they. Mm-hmm. I often wondered how they worship the Lord, or what. Yeah. What do you think?
I don't know. I was just thinking the fact that he was going there as the Lord led him in obedience mm-hmm. and went up there. And that's what I was thinking, that it's obedience. It's everything. Worship is everything.
And he was going to sacrifice
yes.
his son.
And that was a sacrifice.
Which I cannot imagine.
And, yeah. You know, and he was going to offer, and we offer worship. And it's, yes. you know, and we remember the song, we bring the sacrifice
yes. mm-hmm.
of praise,
yes.
you know, into the house of our God. And so he, you know, he loved the Lord so much and obeyed the Lord to the point of believing, beyond the point of believing, that God could give him back his son, that he said, "We're going to go and worship."
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Awesome.
And yeah, that's powerful.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And God did provide.
Oh, yeah, he provided
did.
The lamb.
He did. And he didn't have to sacrifice
no,
his
he
son.
Did
but
not.
Too, when you that one scripture in 2 Chronicles, is it where they were worshiping and praise, and then when during the time of worship and praise, God set ambushments against the enemy.
Yes.
And took care of things. So he takes care of things for us.
Yes.
When we bring that sacrifice and that worship to him.
That's right.
He's working out things in our lives.
Yes. Amen. And I would like, you know, you have such a beautiful voice.
Yes.
I would like those that are with us today to just be able to hear a little bit of yours. So we're going to just take a break, and we're going to hear
yes.
some beautiful worship.
Yes.
Thank you.
Church, your
One with you.
Wow, that was so powerful. Thank you so much. That was awesome. Thank you for sharing
that. Yes. Thank you. Praise the Lord.
It's just, that's a gift. And you truly have many gifts, but that's just a gift. And like we said, sometimes you don't even feel like worshiping, but once you do, it just comes.
Mm. Yeah, it's something too, because being the worshiper that He made me to be, called me to be, it's something that I have to give myself over every day, because actually you could get bottled up inside. And that goes for anybody, really. You get bottled up inside when you don't give that worship out, when you don't express that. I mean, what is it? Psalms 103, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name.
Yes.
He's calling all of us to bless His name, to worship, because God wants to hear that back. But it's not just that He wants to hear that. He wants us to experience Him.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. For sure.
In John 4, chapter 4, verses 23 and 24, it says, the hour is coming and now is when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and
in truth.
For the Father is seeking such to worship Him. And
Amen.
God is a spirit. Verse 24, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and in truth. So to genuinely praise and worship the Lord.
In the spirit.
In the spirit.
Yeah.
Yes.
And He brings us to the place in the spirit. The other scripture I had was, where is it? The one where Ephesians 2:6. He quickened us. That was the previous word before that. And then He says, has raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Uh-huh.
So He lifts us up into that realm with Him, because that wouldn't be in there if it wasn't so.
He does
take us into that place, that heavenly place with Him, into the inner courts.
Mm-hmm.
And He desires that for all of us, because He wants that intimacy.
Yes.
He wants that
Amen.
Relationship.
Yes.
And it's healing. It's healing for us.
Yes.
Yes, it is.
And you shared with us in the previous program about all the losses.
Mm-hmm.
You had so many losses. Your mother, your sisters, your father, your husband. and how did worship help you during that time?
Yes, I had to worship. In fact, you know, people would say, well, you know, maybe you don't need to get up and worship on the worship team right away. But I knew I had to. I knew that I had to do that. And I knew that was healing, and I knew that I was going to go on in faith, trust in God, and give that worship back to Him.
Yes.
Yeah. And He blessed me very much
praise
for that.
God. Yes.
Yeah, praise God.
And I know when you're singing, sometimes you probably don't even feel like you're here, because He does lift you up
in heavenly places.
Yes.
And it's for all of us. It's available to everybody.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Everybody. That's what He's given us.
Yes. I know we just celebrated Pentecost Sunday, and we had a beautiful worship piece, and I don't know if there would be time to put a clip, maybe if not this program, but another program, but the one girl, we were doing like beautiful flags and billows, and
it was beautiful.
She got, thank
you.
Yeah,
it was
but
beautiful.
The girl I was doing with, she got caught up, and she was just worshiping the Lord, and she forgot that we were like supposed to cross, and it was okay. I said, you know what, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
We're worshiping, and it's, you know, sometimes you get caught up, and if you are singing or dancing, and you can dance before the Lord in your bedroom, you know we don't all have to be beautifully trained, but it's nice to when you can see that with somebody.
Yes, unabandoned, that's another one. I mean, but worship Him in spirit and truth. I believe that would be what that is.
Yes.
Worship Him in spirit and truth, truly from your spirit.
Mm-hmm.
You don't worry about who's around you.
Mm-mm.
You just go to that place with Him.
That's right.
And that's the beauty of that.
Yes, and music can take you there.
Oh, yes, it can.
When you put on that beautiful worship music, it lifts you up, and you're in another realm.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's been a lot of craziness going on in the earth right now. We seem like we go from one crisis to another. Yes. We had the COVID thing, and everybody was in their homes and isolated and not being able to meet with people or even hug or touch. I think that was the hardest thing when you had loved ones.
Isolation.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And then now another crisis is in the United States. And, you know, we just have to keep worshiping the Lord through all these things, because the enemy would try to get you so focused. And I have, you know, people that don't know the Lord, if you don't know the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, there's a lot of fear. There's a spirit of fear that has been released.
Yes, there is.
And people are afraid. Mm-hmm. And, you know, those of us that know the Lord, you know, we know that all of this is temporary, as you already know. Our time here, it's a gift. Yes. Whatever days that the Lord gives us, it's a gift from God. And that if you know the Lord Jesus, then you have an eternal home. You know, this program goes on Isaac TV, Eternal Life Ministries. We want to give a shout out to Pastor Omar, Anita. We love you. We miss you.
We do.
And we can't wait till you can come back and be with us. And Eternal Life Ministries, that's the name of his ministry.
Eternal life.
That's right.
Beautiful.
Yes. When you know the Lord Jesus and you have accepted him as your personal Savior, then the devil can't use that trick to that fear, because we know when our time is over, we're going to be with the Lord Jesus forever.
Amen.
And you'll be with your loved ones.
Amen.
All those that have gone on before.
Yes.
So there's no fear. We don't have that fear that seems to be on a lot of people. And so worship, you know, what's the proper motivation for worship? Psalm 100, this is a call to worship. It gives us the answer. Know that the Lord himself is God. It is he who has made us and not ourselves.
Yes.
We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. In Psalm 100, verse 3, come to worship, both corporately, that means together with in a church or in your home group, or privately because of who God is. We worship him for who he is. Not for what he does for us.
Amen.
He alone is worthy of our adoration and praise.
Amen.
And, you know, sometimes it's hard because, like you said, when things aren't going your way or loved ones pass on or you're grieving the loss of a house or a divorce. Some people have gone through deaths and losing children. I can't imagine, Pastor Patty, in the last program you prayed for those. But my own brother-in-law and sister-in-law, they lost a son. They just celebrated 50 years together. You know, and the devil will use those things to try to divide families and husbands and wives. And I just want to pray for those, you know, people that are out there.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Lord Jesus, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit. Lord. Holy Spirit to comfort, Father. We come against all fear, Father, that would try to come on the people, Lord. If you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, open your heart. Ask him to come into your life. Ask him to be the Lord of your life. He forgives you. He forgives you all sins. You don't have to carry that burden. You don't have to carry that shame. Whatever your past, and believe me, we all have a past. The Lord has forgiven us. He can forgive you too. Just ask him. Cry out and ask him to forgive you of your sins. Wash you clean. And accept Jesus into your heart, and he is God's son.
Yes.
He came to this earth and he died for your sins and for all of our sins.
Yes.
So we thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for your salvation. That's what it means to be saved. You ask him to come into your heart and be Lord of your life.
Mm-hmm.
And we are then his. We are his children.
Amen.
Amen.
So thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
So no fear, right?
No fear. No fear.
You come against that spirit of fear.
That's right. No fear. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
You can worship in spirit and truth.
Yes.
When you're free. When you're free, when you're born again, when you're saved, when you commit your life to the Lord, when the scripture says those that worship him will worship him in spirit and truth. Yes, our physical body raises our hands and our voice is used and we do all of that, but really it's a spirit connection.
That's right.
Exactly.
And so
that's it.
You can do that.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And we want to hear from you. We have a website, newcreationwoman.org.
Mm-hmm.
You can write to us, info@newcreationwoman.org, or like us on Facebook. You can communicate with us on Facebook. What a great thing. Now we have videos on there, and so you can see if you missed the other program that you were on.
Yeah.
Is there something else that you wanted to share?
Just that the one other scripture I had was, he said,
open your mouth and I will fill it. Mm-hmm. So if you have a hard time, just open it up, even just literally, and let him help you do that if you have a difficult time.
Yes.
Because it's very freeing for all of us.
And you said you used to be shy. You would never have that.
Well, yeah, he gives you that boldness. And so,
amen.
Yeah.
And me too, because my husband was always the speaker, not me. But God's doing a new thing.
Yes, he is. He's doing a new thing and giving us a new song.
Right, a new song. Thank you. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
So we hope that you'll join us again, that you will invite your friends so you can look on the, see when we're going to be again and use our program as a Bible study.
Yes,
that
would
be wonderful. Get together with your friends, your sisters and brothers in the
Lord. To pray and to talk and share.
Yes.
Amen.
So thankful.
Awesome.
Thankful to Pastor Anwar and Pastor Nita that you allow us, and for you, for letting us come into your homes. And we just want...
It was wonderful, Terry.
Yes.
Thank you for having me. It's a real blessing for me to share.
Thank you. Again. And we hope that you will come on again another time.
Yes. There's always so much more.
There is. And there's more with the Lord. Mm-hmm. So, Pastor Patty, you want to pray for the people?
Yes. Father, thank you. We thank you for this time. We thank you for this fellowship. We thank you for sharing, Lord, the sharing in our spirits and you sharing with us.
Yes.
Father,
thank you
that the people that are watching, they're blessed.
Yes.
We bless them in the name of Jesus.
Lord, your blessing shall overtake them. We thank you for an overtaking of blessings, Lord.
That goodness and mercy will follow all the days of their life.
Yes.
And we bless them in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Oh,
God. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So we want to invite you to tune in again and visit the website, Facebook. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he give you his peace, his love, and his joy in Jesus' name today and forevermore.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. See you next time.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.